Hey, so Sean, what are you doing? David had asked me about the traveler map I was using. Was getting ready to do a video earlier today, and I thought, you know what, I should probably do something about my generator. So here's the generator that makes stars. It makes sectors for traveler. I added a little coordinate thing here. You can go from 0 to 99 for these things. And it'll highlight generate. If you haven't used these coordinates yet, the generate button comes on. Otherwise, it's like, nope. That way you're not overwriting your sector, because the previous version it would overwrite your sector with a new sector. Okay, so when you make a map, you generate it, spits it out. And then when you make another one, you're gonna have to pick another coordinate. So it made it. So now you can't click on it. So now if I need to make another map, I have to pick another place somewhere. Let's see, make this one sparse. Generate. Boom. So now if I were to fire up the map. So now we got this thing here. So these are the two maps I just made, two sectors. One is sparse and one's kind of regular. And it displays the sector names. And then when you zoom in, it doesn't display the subsector names. I need to fix that. I need to have it so it puts the subsector names across the top or something. That's going to be my next thing. But you like the rectangles? As far as the zones, the amber zones, the red zones, you can have it a circle, you can have it filled in, you can have it fill in the whole rectangle if you want. Let's see, are there any red zones? Any red zones? No red zones. We lucked out. Let's see, you can toggle the trade codes for the planets. You can turn off the grid. You can turn off the location. Turn off the zone things. Or just leave them like that, I suppose. So now they're just free floating worlds. There's like nothing here. There's like, I'm looking for the capitals. I'm looking for overpopulated worlds, that kind of thing. Guess we lucked out that time. I can zoom out. We'll go to this one. Was I in this one? Oh yeah, this one's more crowded. Okay, let's look for red zones. Hey, here's a planet that's red. This is the capital. It was a capital. It's now an asteroid. Another capital. Here's one. Okay, so we got some capitals. Got a red zone here. Let's see what happened here. What's going on? What are you guys doing next to your sister planet here? You guys are having problems? You guys are having issues? Let's see. Man, you can make a real, let's make a dense planet. Let's see. Where are you? Come back in here, Sector Gen. Let's make one super dense. It's packed. Chance of super Earths based on planet size for the water. Make it Soleimani. Why not? Fire away. That's a lot of planets. That's a lot. So let's zoom out here. What we got? Oh yeah, here's the Glorious. Glorious gold color. It looks like the whole thing's amber zone. Look how packed these are, you know. You can't go anywhere without bumping into a planet now. Anyway, you can still do the hex thing if you wanted to. I like the rectangles though. It's weird seeing gaps here. What happened to these planets? How come there's no. Where's all the planets at? This is not normal. This is a core. This is a true core system where it's like super populated. It's so populated that they don't have time to name this planet anything, so it still has its original UWP. I thought there'd be more red zones. I guess these two guys are having issues. These are kind of like dieback worlds where they just blow themselves up. Because there's no people, no government, no law level. Here's another one. Blowed itself up. Anyway. So David wanted to see a video, so here's a video. Yay!